Hey everyone, Steelworks Ryan here. Now, for those of you who are in the church and wondering why I'm calling myself that is because I can't say my real name on YouTube because no. And I also can't show my face on YouTube because no too. So you're going to be staring at this original character, aka OC, whenever I talk or have something to say. Now, for those of you who just came to see the music video, too bad, you gotta sit through this first. So here's a little introduction about why I chose this for my school project. As a kid, my TV interests were a lot different than anyone else's. I was always fascinated with a model series show called Thomas the Tank Engine, and the cool thing about this show was that the models moved on their own, like it wasn't stop motion animation, they were actually powered through their tracks, and it looked so real. They all looked like real steam engines even though they were just models. And the show was very successful for many years. However, that wasn't until the year 2000 when the team made a big mistake with one of their movies that literally destroyed the entire show. The reason why the people in the Thomas fandom love Thomas so much is because he seems like a real train that you could just go to his island and meet him in real life. However, this movie completely shatters Thomas's reputation and says that the engines are only alive because of a steam engine that has magic powers.
Follow me, partner. Ooh. Right this way to Bufferville. Just a walk in the park.
You're going through, Lily.
You're on your own from here on in, little blue buckaroo. Yeah.
Little engines can do big things.
What was in that toothpaste I used last night?
The movie was a complete failure, and Britt Allcroft got fired because the team had lost too much money. The team pushed on for a good few more years, and they made three more pretty good seasons. However, a company called Hit Entertainment later bought the show, and they turned it into the one thing that Thomas and Friends was trying not to be. An ordinary, everyday kid show. Mattel fixed the show for a few years, and then broke it in their own creative way! Yay! Okay, you get the point. Thomas the Tank Engine was never meant to be a show where the trains only talked because magic and it was just meant to be an average everyday kid show. No, it was much more than that. Thomas and Friends was meant to be a show that anyone of any age could enjoy. However, after that movie came out, Thomas's reputation was shattered and everyone started seeing it as a normal kid show. That's why we in the Thomas fandom make our own creations so that way we can keep the legacy of classic Thomas alive. And for my project, I made a music video based on a movie I'm hoping to make one day once I have all the props. One thing I'd advise if you're filming with models is that you clean them off after you're done filming them, because they do collect dust and dirt, and they do collect germs if you take them outside, and this kind of stuff can make you sick. I found this out the hard way. I used to film on my bed for Pete's sake. Now obviously this video wasn't perfect, a few of the props were a bit rough around the edges, especially Thomas, seeing that he was just a recolor of one of my stunt double Thomases, but overall I'm really happy with how this turned out. If I were to improve on one thing, it would definitely be the fact that you can see the string pulling Thomas along. I'd rather use like fishing wire for that, but for this I use dental floss. That's something I need to improve on. Oh well. And something that I learned is that I need to go outside more because I filmed one scene on a steep hill in my backyard and it was extremely painful for my legs. That must mean something. Now, there's one more thing I want to talk about before I show you the actual video. If you look at this shot right here from Thomas's flashback, you can see that a man is showing Thomas the Bible. And if you look next to Thomas, you can see that there's another engine beside him. Now, this engine also has a face. But what I did is I put a truck in front of the engine to hide the face. This is what the team that made the show would sometimes do. They would usually hide the engine's faces to make it seem all the more real. Sure, we did see the engine's faces, but that was only the ones that were important to the story. The ones that weren't, the faces were usually covered up to make it look more realistic. Now you're probably all asking, why am I so passionate about a show with a blue train with a face? There's like millions of those in this world. To be honest, I don't know. Once I saw season 5 of Thomas the Tank Engine, I was immediately hooked, and I never let go. And Thomas and Friends has inspired me to do great things. And I'm hoping one day that I'll be able to revive an old model show that ended a few years ago and keep the legacy of models alive. I know the techniques are outdated, but so much hard work and effort went into model shows, and I want that work to be remembered. And all Thomas and Friends really needs right now is the correct writers, and it can be saved. Anyway, you've heard enough of my rambling. You just want to see the actual video. Enjoy. It's all the way down there. See? Right there. I'm not going down there. There's snakes in there. He's stuck there forever. Yeah.
Our fabulous God gave me strength to get him out of the snake pit. Yay!